Well, you get effectively an exposure to technology, which is one of the most interesting assets in Europe. So, you know, companies are growing. And this is where the growth is coming from. So you get that exposure, but with a better downside protection than if you were just investing in equity. So that's one of the benefits. You know, for us, we look at generating equity returns with debt risk. So what we do is we would identify companies that are growing fast, that have an amazing technology, and we will lend to them. And on top of the loans, we also get warrants. So when the companies are successful, we benefit from this upside. And what's important in our job is not to be effectively lending with, let's say, an equity risk, but a debt return. Well, we're a proxy of the venture equity investors and the technology equity investors. And the technology assets and the amount of money flowing into European technology companies has been multiplied by 5 over the last 5 years. So for us, there is more and more opportunity to lend to companies that need the money for growth. And it just is transforming our assets, which maybe used to be seen as a niche asset, and now is becoming an emerging asset. And I think for limited partners, it creates an opportunity to allocate to different type of players and to look at it as potentially a way to enhance their portfolio. So it's fascinating because we are at the crossroad between private debt and technology. Yeah, well, you know, it's a fair question because when you lend to technology company, there is a perception of risk because they're fast growing. They usually have a small or to no history of profitability. It's because they're investing in their growth. And so the perceived, let's say, way of looking at our assets is to think it's extremely risky. But in reality, our loss ratios for us are 1.6% over 15 years. And this shows you that we're actually less risky than commercial lending. So there is a misconception of the risk, and also it's a mispriced asset as a result. Well, the technology investing and the way we invest through growth debt is not new. It exists, you know, probably potentially it started in the 60s, it exists. So there is a lot of history of how this is actually performing. And, you know, in Europe, it's been, you know, since the end of the 90s. So you also have that history and those teams with track record that, you know, where investors can look at those returns and decide if they think it's a good asset or not. And you can see, because the returns have been tested during the tech crash post the 2000s years, and it's also been tested in a credit crunch more recently. So you have history of the, you know, of the cyclicality of the returns as well.